Hi guys, my name is Anne Greis. I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. This time we will take a look at how we can implement a gradient background like you can see here in Jetpack Compose. Let's not wait any longer and get right to it. Here in Android Studio, we open up the basic template for an empty activity with Jetpack Compose. And as you can see here in the preview, it's just a blank screen with a simple text on it. The goal here is now that we improve the UI with a nice gradient background. So we start by creating a new composable and we call it gradient background brush. And of course it's composable. And we also want to enable it to be either linear or horizontal. So we say is linear gradient as a boolean, as an input parameter. And then we also want a list of colors. So at the end, we want to return a linear gradient brush that is either laid out horizontally or vertically. We need three essential things to create the linear gradient. That is first the colors, and then the start and an end offset. So if we quickly type in brush.linearGradient, we can see that we have two overloads. We will stick to the second one and say colors and apply our colors here, or list of colors. And the start offset is always offset.0, which refers to 0.0 on the X and also on the Y axis. We take a look at here. To get a quick impression what it's all about with these offsets, let's have a look at a sketch here. So this is supposedly our screen. And now the start offset is right in this corner here. So we say 0.0, where this is the point for the x-axis and this is the point for the y-axis. So both are at 0. Now if we want to align the gradient on the horizontal axis, we have to say this x point is positive infinite and this point here on the y-axis is still 0. So we stay here at the top right corner. If we want to align it on the vertical axis, so this way, we just say the point on the x-axis is still 0 and on the y-axis this time it's positive infinity. If we now get back to Android Studio, we can, okay, I just recognized this should be this vertical gradient. And we can now say if the gradient should be vertical, then we can say offset 0 on the x-axis and float positive infinity. Of course, this should also be a float value. And then for the horizontal alignment, we just say offset float positive infinity and 0f for the y-axis. So just like we just saw it in the small sketch I showed you. And now nothing more to do than adding the end offset to the brush linear gradient. Say the end offset. And now we of course need to adapt the return type and we are done. Now in order to apply this gradient brush to our background, we only need to say background brush equals our new created gradient brush background. And of course, now we need to say if it should be vertical. We say true here. And now we also need to add a gradient color list. As an example, let me quickly copy this list here of yellow shades. And now if we run the preview, we can see we have a nice linear gradient background. And let's quickly test also the alignment works. Let's set this to a false. And now we should see that the gradient is aligned horizontally. And that's already it. As you saw, it's very easy to do. I remember in the old XML ways, we had to create own drawables and so on. Here it's quite easy. And it's also very convenient to adapt the list of colors you want to apply. And yeah, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.